On resignation day, this was the scene at Cardinal Keith O'Brien's house. Plenty of media interest in the cleric at the centre of scandal, but no sign of the man himself. What there was confirmation he was stepping down forthwith. It was just 24 hours after details emerged that priests had accused Britain's most senior member of the Catholic Church of inappropriate behaviour. A Vatican news conference brought confirmation that the Pope had agreed he should go.
The Holy Father accepted on February the 18th the resignation from the office of Archbishop of St. Andrews in Edinburgh in Scotland of Cardinal O'Brien.
Cardinal O'Brien had been due to fly to Rome tomorrow to join the conclave to elect a new Pope. In a statement, he said, "The Holy Father has now decided that my resignation will take effect today. I do not wish media attention in Rome to be focused on me, but rather on Pope Benedict and on his successor. Looking back over my years of ministry, for any good I have been able to do, I thank God. For any failures, I apologise to all whom I have offended." The Catholic Church insists the Cardinal is contesting the claims and seeking legal advice. This is an episode that's damaged the Church and shocked its members. This was lunchtime mass at Glasgow's St Andrew's Cathedral, immediately following the Cardinal's resignation.
I think he's an honest, decent man, yes, definitely. I think he's tried to always represent the good in the Church, whatever the case.
I suppose in his early days he must have been a fine man in that light, you know, just it's quite shocking.
The resignation was prompted by the allegations of three priests currently serving and one man who left the priesthood. A Sunday newspaper revealed they'd complained to the Vatican at the start of the month, claiming that as far back as the 1980s, Cardinal O'Brien was guilty of inappropriate behaviour towards them when they were young men. The details of what that behaviour was, for now, remain a mystery. But what isn't is how damaging the timing and nature of this episode is for the Catholic Church as it prepares to elect a new Pope. In the absence of a British presence in the conclave, there will be no British vote.
There will be a natural human reaction of probable disappointment that he isn't there, Cardinal O'Brien. But the cardinals are focused there on the election of the next successor to St. Peter. That will completely focus their attention.
Cardinal O'Brien had been due to retire in any case next month. This premature, messy end is not one he wanted or his church needed. James Matthews, Sky News, Edinburgh.